Cha, Dvitiyam Brahmacharini, Tritiyam Chandragantiti, Kushmanteti Chaturthakam, Panchamam Skandamateti, Shastyam Katyayaniti Cha, Saptamam Kalaratriti, Mahaguriti Chastramam, Navamam Siddhidatri Cha, Navadurga Prakirtita, Uktanye Tarinamani, Paramanava Mahatmanaha.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, hello, I'm Himalaya, oh my gosh, really? I can't even say my own name this morning. It's Monday morning. What is happening? Hi, I'm having one of those moments. I had a real weekend, that's what happened. And so here we are on this series, welcome. We are in Body Freedom, and we are creating tools and techniques, bringing you information, practices from a lot of practices from the ancient traditions for this modern day chaos and sanity, whatever you want to call it. So we are here for you. We have musical guests join us. We have guest transformational facilitators join us. And our intention is to provide great practices for you to be filled with. So yeah, the series is designed. It's designed to ground us in a whole new embodiment of leadership, because fear and stress and anxiety are going to attempt to throw us off our center again and again and again. So let's thrive by reclaiming and sustaining our joy and pleasure through movement, breath, play, fun, and presence, like coming back into higher presence. And you'll have an experience of what that means. So this particular series is Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. We go live Pacific Coast time, and 11 a.m. for the East Coasters. So everyone take a deep breath in. Deep breath in, deep breath in, deep breath in. Hold the breath for a moment. Exhale. This is not a show just to watch or listen alone. The invitation is going to be for you to be in the experience with us. It's an experiential, invitational series. So let's walk it out here. Walk yourself from side to side. Roll your shoulders around and take up space here. Stretching out, maybe it is the morning for you, depending on where you are in the world, and stretch it out. Breathe here and stretch from side to side. Our intention is to also invite you to be in your body, right? We can abandon the body. So jiggle the body here. We can abandon the body when we go into fear or stress or anxiety, right? The way that you know that you're abandoning your body is like you're way up in here, the head, the mind, just like churning and bugging you and overly trying to figure shit out. So we want to come into our body, our higher state of connection, that deep place within us. So take your breath all the way in. So even plant your feet right now and take the breath all the way down deep into your body. Grab your kiddos, bring them in so we can move together. I promise I won't swear anymore. Bounce your shoulders, shake it out here. Shake out the hands, the arms. Open the mouth. So through sound vibration, through movement, through breath. Okay, now let's take the hips around in a big circle. Big morning hip scoops. Big morning awakening of the body, of the pathways that do create openings for you to experience joy and pleasure. And today we've got an awesome, beautiful sister of mine here, a soul sister, Shazia Imam, is here. And one of her superpowers is pleasure. And so we get to play in that today. So twist here. Your torso twisting. You can keep your hips facing forward. Ooh, I had a little adjustment. Whoo! And then push out your arm now as you extend across your body. Ah, yes. Waking up the muscles, your physical body, your energetic body. Now go up diagonal as you cross. Whoo! make a sound here. All right, jiggle it out in the center. Jiggle, 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 jiggle. We're going to roll down to stand, roll down to forward fall. So drop your head, your arms roll down. Keep your knees bent, standing firmly with your legs. Let the head hang over. Breathe here. Shake out your head. Let the head go. You can even grab the back of the neck and interlace the hands. Oh. And stop resisting with your head. Internal om here. What does it feel like when you stop resisting, when you let go? Let the arms go now. Keep your feet flat on the ground. You can even spread your toes. You can utilize your fingers to spread your toes, create some space in between your toes, using the strength of your toes. And keep your knees bent. Really vibrate the legs as you roll up to standing. Slowly. The head, the arms, the last thing to come up. Good. Just a little wake up movement here. Head is the last thing to come up. Roll the shoulders around. Move your head from side to side. Breathe here. Stretch out your mouth. Yeah, we're stretching out of our mask. Any of that mask that we wear. You can massage your head here. So I've been doing this little massaging, moving my scalp around, getting out of that agitation that happens in our mind. So take those pads of your fingers all around your head. Oh yeah. And underneath the back of where your spine meets your skull. Get your thumbs in there. Like, I like getting my thumbs in there. Breathe here. Flubber your lips. All right. Shake it out. Beautiful. Good morning, Bhavan. Good morning, everyone. Where are you connecting in from today? Move your head from side to side. Those of you who are here, take a moment to type in where you are connecting in from, where we have the pleasure of being in connection with you. All right, taking in some deep breaths in. We're going to create our intention for today. So what is it that you are calling in? What is it that you're creating in your life? What is it that you are? So close your eyes for a moment, palms face up, or you can bring your fingertips together and create a big, spacious mudra here. Lots of space in between your palms and your fingertips touch each other and your thumbs touch. This is the mudra. This is the hand gesture for higher intuition, higher intuition. So deep breath in here. Eyes are softly closed. Shh. Create that sound on the exhale and empty everything out. Keep your knees bent slightly if you're standing here. If you're sitting, straighten out your back. Arch your lower back slightly. And reach your heart up towards the sky and your tailbone down. Standing, your feet are going to root down deep into the earth. Your tailbone is also going to go down towards the earth. You can even pulse your pelvis forward and back. Beautiful. Good morning, Penny. Awesome. So the whole intention of our beginning of our practice here is to open up to our receptive mode, open up your pathways to receiving. You receiving this movement, this breath in this moment, your highest connection with the divine, whatever that looks like for you, and your highest connection with your true self. So this is what we are creating together here. So the invitation is for you to get on board, get online. with your true self. Because fears and all the externals will make us feel like that's the only choice, is to spin out. Well, I'm inviting you into diving in, spiraling inward, coming into deep connection with that part of you that is knowing that you have a superpower. Okay, deep breath in, deep breath in, deep breath in. Thank you, allies, support team, devas and devis, archangels, angels, divine beings, God, goddess, all of the higher realm beings of benefic love and light. Thank you for coming in and supporting us. Feel yourself held here in this space. And all of those frontline workers out there right now that don't have the time to take this breath in this moment, we're taking this breath and moment for you, with you, and holding you with your angels and allies supporting you. Thank you for the work that you do. Thank you for those of you who are delivering our groceries right now and supporting us from all of it. May you also be supported in your immune system. Energetic system, your physical body, all of it. Take a deep breath in, blast out our prayers for those and yourself and your families and your communities. Awesome. Open your eyes, move your head from side to side again, roll your shoulders around, flubber your lips, stretch out your mouth. Bounce your shoulders. Awesome. Whee! Have a little sound. Make a little sound. Whee! So this is one of the quickest ways I know on how to get out of my own way, is by making sounds, moving my body, taking in breaths, stretching out my mouth, and my face. Flubbering my lips. So you get to choose bits and pieces from what you learn here today and every day, that you get to pick up these pieces and bring it into your life. Don't watch. Be in the game. All right. We have our beautiful divine sister who I get to introduce you to. Shazia Imam is coming on in just a moment. And before she gets here, I really want you to know, so her and I got to be in a leadership group together. She's an extraordinary human being and such a phenomenal powerhouse woman. She's also the award-winning speaker and the host of the Top 12 podcast. It's called Feminine and Fulfilled, also known as the Life Engineer. Shazia's a certified life coach. But her previous life was an engineer with 2 decades of experience in Fortune 500 companies. And she left it all to follow her soul's calling to help women unleash their authentic selves and life purposefully. So her and I have that deeply in common, that we love to empower women. Welcome, Shazia Imam.
Ah, hey, hello. Oh my God, I'm so excited to be here. I'm like, really grounded, really ready. Like, I wore this shirt in your honor. Look.
Thank you. That's awesome. Perfect. That's actually perfect. I'll just put a little seed in right now, a little plug in. We have a dance challenge, embody dance challenge, that starts today. So you wore the shirt on the right day, sister.
Totally aligned.
So let's share with everyone, where in the world are you?
So I live right now, I am in Dallas, Texas, but I am from Washington, D.C. So I'm an East Coast girl and learning to adjust in Texas, which really could be a country on its own.
I know. It's really big. Oh, my gosh. I actually love Texas. As you know, we were going to have our Embody there this year. And, yeah, you were going to be coming, which is really awesome. So when did you move to Texas?
I moved here. It's been 4 years now. Okay. I got married. So that's
what he lives there. Is that what happened?
He lives here, yeah.
Okay, got you. Okay. But so love brought you to Texas.
Huh?
Love brought you to Texas.
Love, yes.
Beautiful. Well, tell us, I want to hear about your podcast. I want to hear about this because it sounds really powerful. I mean, I've heard some, but I want everyone else to know about it too.
Yeah. So I created this podcast called Feminine and Fulfilled, and it's really about feeling, just as it says, feeling feminine and feeling fulfilled. Because one of the things that I was realizing about women, and especially my own life story, is we check off all these boxes. Our life is like a set of check boxes that we're checking off. And it's always feeling like, okay, once we finish this checklist, everything's going to be done and we're going to feel fulfilled. And what I found through my own life experience is that all the checkboxes in the world will not give you the feeling that you're searching for until you decide to feel it yourself. And I had to come to that realization in my own life when everything fell apart. And I realized that those checkboxes were unraveling and I was only left with me. So this podcast is really a space for women to know that it's already within you. There's nowhere to go. It's always been in you, and it's just time to unleash it so that you can feel fulfilled now.
Beautiful. Yeah, I can certainly relate with so many women that we work with. So what do you feel is like one of the most powerful tools for women to come into that? Because what I heard you say is it's when you realized, how did you say it? It's when you realize that the women are, okay, sorry. I'm yeah.
It's Monday.
It is so Monday, and I haven't had any coffee. Where's our assistant? Oh, there's not one. Okay. Yeah. Well, what I was going to say is not what are you struggling with, but what do you find women are struggling? Oh, that's what it was. It's like us coming home. Like when you said, it's just me. Like when it came down to it, it was just me. So like, what is that thing for women when it comes, like, do we have to go through all of this and go, oh my God, at the end of it? No, we get to like, you know, what do you say to cut through that for women? Because we don't have to go through the whole thing.
Yes, and some of us have to. Some of us have to be in control.
Oh, right. The controller. Yes, yes.
It takes a little bit longer. So the first thing I would say is to let go.
Yeah.
The first thing is really to just let go and get connected to what is it that you want to feel. Oftentimes we're looking for the thing, and it's like the thing is not actually going to bring the feeling. The feeling will bring the thing. Mm-hmm. And this is so counterintuitive to everything we've ever learned, because it's always like, oh, get the good job, find the relationship, have the money, like all this stuff. And especially, let's be honest, those of you from any South Asian background, Indians in the house, we know, oh my gosh, the pressure, the pressure for all the things. And so as you're on this quest for things, the quest will never end. So just first let go, decide, how do I want to feel? It's like the easiest question, but start with that. How do I want to feel? If it's happy, fulfilled, peaceful, balanced, and then decide to feel it. And you will find that then the things will come in to support that. But we've been working on the opposite paradigm for way too long.
Yeah, yeah. I totally hear you. I mean, and that segues perfectly into pleasure, right? Like, how do we cultivate our own pleasure? Like, one of your superpowers is leading pleasure and luxury and us feeling that. So how would you like, so for those, like, I know that there's some sisters here that are actually watching right now and listening in, there is that scarcity, like it's like really ingrained and it's really coming up strong right now, right? It's a fear time. So if someone wants to feel luxury right now, but they're experiencing scarcity, what would you say? What would you suggest?
Such a good question, because this is the best time to tap into it and realize that, again, it takes nothing. Like, we are in a time right now where you cannot go anywhere. You can't distract yourself by going somewhere to do something, to feel something. It's like you are with yourself, and that can be a difficult place, but pleasure is everywhere and it's mostly within. So sometimes it starts with the most simple thing. So let me just ask a question. Does everybody eat food? Do you eat, Himalaya?
I do eat food, yes.
You eat, yes. We all eat, but most of the time this is an experience where we're just stuffing food in our face. And these days, stuffing a lot of food, because I'm going back to the kitchen many, many, many times. What you can do, something really, really simple you can do, is take the time to really savor your food, to really just taste it. And I remember I first heard about this from Christina Campbell, and she was in that leadership with us.
Yes.
And when I started to do this very simple exercise of savoring my food, tasting it, feeling the textures, like closing my eyes, like even right now, if somebody's watching and you're munching on something, like just slow down and like really be in it. Like, that's what pleasure is. It's like slowing down, savoring, feeling, and it's very sensory and textural. And it's just, you can have that with one bite of food.
Yeah.
Like, when you connect to that, like, there's something visceral too, like, that you have. And so I always recommend that pleasure doesn't have to be something you like have to go and create. Pleasure can be in exactly what you're already doing, but just becoming conscious, becoming present, being in it. Like, that, like, that's the ultimate luxury. Like, nobody can take that from me, because that's mine. Mm. And that's what we have innately. Like, we have this freedom to be in pleasure, just the same way we can be in a lot of other things. So why not choose pleasure?
I love that. And you know, as I was experiencing you, I was remembering yesterday, I've been making a lot of food, right? And making a lot of food. This kitchen is in full production. Plus, we got all of our groceries. We thought we weren't going to get them until like 2 weeks. But we bought, anyways, way too much, which is great. I'm learning how to freeze stuff and all of that. But I made this soup, and I was sitting there yesterday, and it was, because I actually have the weekends off mostly now. You know, it's kind of nice. You know, as an entrepreneur, we don't have a lot of time off. But anyways, I was sitting there and I'm like, like feeling the vibration, like that sound vibration. I was like, wow, yes, that's right. And it is slowing down. I love that you shared that. So those of us, you know, out there really hear Shazia speak into the slowing down, what it can create for you as we're in this time. Would you speak specifically to any money stuff coming up, like how to create that feeling with money, you know, when there's like such a fear or a spiral downward, you know, right now, because food is awesome and we get it with food. How can we create, what would you suggest?
Okay. So with money, here is, again, it's going to be so counterintuitive. With money, you have to tap into the vibration of having it. So here's what I want to share with everybody watching. There is no lack of money in the world. Mm-hmm. There isn't. It might feel like you aren't tapped into it. It might feel like, I wish I had more. Sure. But understand that when you realize that there is no lack of money, and the visual I always give is, imagine, remember those, they used to have those game shows and you used to like stand in like this booth, and then they would like turn on the air blower and all this money would be like,
and you had to grab it.
And you got to grab it, and like whatever you get grabbed was yours. So here's the thing. That's the universe. That's the world that we live in. We are actually in a space where money is everywhere. So when I was speaking earlier about wanting to, like, for those of us who like to feel in control, think about it. If you're so wanting to control what you have and you're feeling scarce. Like if you were to hold your hands like this, this is the feeling like when you're trying to hold on to something. And that's what we do with money. We hold, and just look like it's so tight. And if you imagine that all these bills are flowing around, all this money's flowing around, how can you grab it if you're holding on so tightly to like the little tiny like bit that you feel like you have? So energetically, and even physically, like opening up your hands and realizing that you are part of the universe. You are part of this world that has, there's plenty of money right now. No matter what anybody's saying, no matter what's happening with the stock market, no matter what's happening with your bank account, there is money. You get to decide, but you get to be a part of it, that you can open up your hands and you can grab it too. And I know somebody out there saying, well, Shazia, like, how does that work? And here's the thing, like, it's not about the how. It's first about really believing and tapping into the energy, to first tap into the energy of believing that you are worthy of grabbing this abundance. Mm-hmm. This is the first step. Like, this is the first step. When you match this energy, when you believe without a doubt that I am part of this currency, right? The current of currency. Yeah. And it's in flow. And you get into a flow, the money will come. I mean, there's so many stories. There are so many success stories in my life, Himalaya, I imagine your life. Mm-hmm. Even with the like the beautiful person watching right now, I know you can think back to a time where when you were in flow, and abundance was just coming to you. This is really the law of abundance. It's not like, what does my bank account say? How much, you know, is, do I have how much? Yes, be an adult, be, you know, do the adulting things.
Yeah.
But at the core of it, at the core is to allow yourself to open up your hands and say, I am worthy of receiving. I am wealthy. I am a money magnet. To really call into all this abundance that's there, because it's there, it's just waiting, and we get to have it too.
Yes, I love that, Shazia, and I do. I recognize and experience you as abundant and prosperous, and you know, and that piece that you just talked about, which is the worthiness. Will you say more about that? Because I feel like that is definitely the missing piece. For women especially, is that worthiness piece?
It's everything.
Yeah.
It is everything. Everything comes back to deciding, like, I am worthy enough to receive money, love, even pleasure, the thing that we have access to all the time. Here's the thing. Anybody who needs a permission slip, I'm writing it for you right now, okay? I even have a clipboard. I am writing. I am giving you permission right now, okay, girl? Like, you are worthy.
Yeah.
And I say that with this deep love because I know, like, somebody gets to hear that right now.
Yes, you are worthy. Now.
And why? Because you are, period. Period.
Yeah.
That's it. Yeah. Nothing determines our worth except that we exist, except that we were created in this divine perfection. Like every single one of us, divinely created. And when you tap into this beautiful essence that you are, of course you're worthy. Of course. Like, let's all have a seat at the table. Let's even create our own tables.
Let's create our own table. Yes. Mm-hmm. I love that. Yeah, yeah. I've been saying that a lot to the Embody Leadership Masterclass, you know, when we went through that. It's like, make your own stage. Those of you who are leaders right now, you make your own stage just like this platform right now, you know. You see this. And Shazia with the podcast and all of that. You leaders, it's time for us to rise and stand in your worthiness. Like, that's what I hear from what you're initiating us into right now, Shazia.
Yes. You know, there's this really simple question that I always say to move from. Instead of saying, why me? because we all have the little voice that says, why me? Like, why me? And I say, why not you? Like, why not you? Mm. That's like, we all have this inner calling. We all have this thing bubbling up. Or, well, I know many of us do. I won't speak for all of us. But for the woman who's like feeling that, you can't hide it anymore. Yeah, it's like I call it your roar. Like, it's roaring to come out. Like, you know, like, and I just say, unleash your roar. Can we record that? I need that exact roar. That was amazing.
You got it, girl. I'll give it to you.
My roar is like, roar.
Actual sound. Your roar is like a little tiger. It's a BB tiger. It's so cute. Roar. Oh, so cute. Yeah, so out there, all of you sisters, where's your roar? Let us hear it. You know, and actually, you know what you're giving us right now? Shazia, this week we're going to be doing the dance challenge. It's called the Embody Dance Challenge in the Embody Sisterhood group. So those of you who are joining us, come and join us on our sisterhood group. But this week...
That's a good group, by the way. I'm in it too.
Oh, good. Yes, yes, yes. Awesome. So this week we're doing a dance challenge. I'm going to add in the money dance challenge, like the worthy, abundant, luxurious, pleasure-filled dance challenge. You just did it. We've been initiated.
Yes.
Shazia.
Yes. And then roar out.
Yes.
What you're worthy of. Like, let it out. Like, scream it. Yell it. You know, like, we get to have it too. Like, I'm tired of, like, thinking it's for somebody else.
Yeah.
It's for us.
It's for us. Yeah. Oh, I love that. And that's the trap that women get into big time, right? Because we're so doing all the time for others that this doesn't get filled up. And so that's where the scarcity can live really strongly and hang out there, or the unworthiness. Because if we're not giving to ourselves, then we're playing into that we're not worthy enough.
Absolutely.
So what would you say, like, what, you know, we've been asking everyone, is like, what's your one thing? What's your one thing that you feel is greatly supportive right now to embody your freedom? What is that thing?
Oh my God. I totally get this from you too. It's a dancing. Dancing.
Yeah.
It is the best. Ah! Oh, I see. Oh, I see.
Gorgeous.
You. See you. That's my website.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So dancing, I mean, it is like the body movement. You know what you started with today, Himalaya, about being stuck up here? Mm-hmm. Oh, I know that story. I mean, I'm like always like, stop, turn off. How do I turn off? But the way to move the focus from here to here to down here, let's keep it PG, folks, but you know.
Right. The pleasure zones, all of the pleasure zones.
All of the pleasure zones, like, is through movement. And it wasn't until I found this, like, the somatic, I guess it's called, like the movement, the body, that I felt like I was like, this is what I've been looking for my whole life. Yeah. This is what I was like. And I feel like in dance and movement, and totally imperfectly, I'm not a dancer. I like have no professional background, but allowing myself to be free to move, it really allows me to be in this vibration that I talked about earlier, to attract in all of those things. So Lucy's saying can totally relate about dancing, right? Like, dancing's the best, the best. And I love dancing in front of the mirror. That's the extra credit version.
Ooh, bonus points, bonus points. Yeah. Bonus worthiness points, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Oh, DTO's got a little. Yeah, girls.
Your nose is strong, everyone.
So get up, ladies. Let's dance. With Shazia, myself. We're doing the worthiness dance. Grab that money.
Grab money. Imagine yourself as a little kid. Like a little kid saying no to a nanny, they're like, no, I want some, I want some, give me some, give me some.
Can you hear us? Just let us know. Make sure that you can hear Shazia, because she's definitely.
So I was saying, now I can. Not just dollar bills, okay? Grab the Benjamin. You're worthy of the Benjamin.
Remember, girls, right? Girls, you want to have pleasure. You want to have abundance.
Grab those Benjamins. Feel it like you're rolling around. And all the things that you want. And the best part is to just laugh and have fun. Nobody is recording except for recording us. You get to do this and have fun. They wanna have fun.
Bounce it out, ladies. Come on. Show us what you got. Especially starting today. You're invited to make your Embody Dance Challenge videos in the Embody Sisterhood. Come and join us if you're not with us yet.
I cannot wait to see
come
the
and
videos.
Play.
How can you not have fun? How can you not have fun doing that?
Exactly. So see what one song can do for us. Shift the energy right away. Because we can easily go spiraling and hang out there. You know what I'm saying?
Totally. Totally. So turn on whatever song it is. Dance it out. Have fun. There's no perfect. For my perfectionists out there, make it imperfect and fun. And Himalaya, yes, I make it the money dance.
Yeah.
Grabbing the Benjamins.
Yeah. That's awesome. We could get Lance and Ronchi with that one. Oh, look what Phyllis says. Love it. Thank you for this. Beautiful. And Lucy, great. Yay. And Doe's been here too, dancing. Beautiful, everyone. Thank you for joining. And Shazia, thank you for playing and sharing and sharing your abundant, luxurious, pleasure-filled self. Is there anything you want to add in or share with anybody here, everyone here?
You know, the last thing I do want to add is that I think sometimes even when it comes to pleasure and fun and just like rocking it out like that, I think sometimes what I hear often from my clients and women is like, I don't know how to do that. Like, what should I do? Like, what does it mean to have fun? And to me, what I want to say is just imagine yourself as a youngin, like a little girl. Like, what did she want to do? What did your five-year-old self want to do? And if you're like, even if that feels like, I don't know, then think about any other five-year-old kid you see. They are just so living and having fun and everything is like just expressed, whether it's like happiness or sadness or anger, like kids don't hold back. And we get to have that. We get to have that girlishness, that childlikeness again, that curiosity, that expression. So just full permission to go back into that part of you that really like just knows and wants to come out. And that's where all of the things will flow.
Beautiful. Take it in, ladies. Take it in, everyone. Take a deep breath in. Oh, well, blast Shazia with so much appreciation for sharing her gifts. And thank you for bringing your beautiful heart and your wisdom and your leadership here. We really, really appreciate you. And thanks for playing and make it fun.
And the work you're doing. Thank you. Because sometimes when I don't know what I should do, I'll do some video where you're dancing. And I'm like, oh, yeah, Himalaya is saying, take up the space. And I'm like, okay. And I love it. I do it with you. So thank you for creating
the work. Oh, that's great to know. Good. Somebody's enjoying it out there. Yes. That's good. Awesome. Well, we're going to bring you back in just a couple minutes here, and we're going to pick a card together. So, yay.
I'll be dancing in the background.
Okay, good. Excellent. Yes, keep it going. Keep it moving. And this weekend, we had the opportunity, DTO and I, you can see our setup. Our setup's a little different here, right? We got DTO's play in the background here. And we got to be on Lucidity Festival. So Lucidity Festival was going to be this weekend, or was this weekend, past weekend. We would have been camping out there in the Santa Barbara Mountains and, you know, with everybody. And it was raining. So honestly, camping out in our home was a lot better. But nonetheless, we got to share in this whole new way. It was really powerful. So DTO's pulled some clips from our weekend so you can have a little taste of what festival online looks like. All right.
Awesome. All right, let these drums get into your body, into your being. That same move, right? The booty back. Walk it out side to side. Woo! You can turn. All right. Yes. Get those drums in. Yeah, DTO, get it. So let your heart go forward and back here. This is what it looks like, right? A heart going forward and back. Yes. Which will allow your pelvis to go forward and back. Move your head from side to side. It's almost like a march. Woo! And then from here, you get to play. Whatever it looks like. Whatever you do, make so much sound and fun. Snap it out, clap it out. Woo! Let every cell in your being become contagious with joy, with freedom, with liberation, with play. Woo! Shake it out, play. Huddled together in a circle right now, and the energy is building. The energy is building. Let it drop. Go. Woo. Woo. Yes.
Oh, that's okay.
Woo. Yes. You are on the dance floor of the stage of your life. You are being called to shine. You are being called to lead. Woo! You are being called to show up. Yes. Yes. You could even punch it out in front here and go back to that sound. Yes. Hey, hey, hey.
Okay, wrap it up.
Oh my gosh. That just took me right back. So if you can see, am I echoing out there? Okay, great. That was really quite the experience to be able to be like that online. And I don't know if you noticed, but I was a little resistant to DTO swinging me around. I was like, what do you want? What do you want? Because I'm, when I'm, you know, in the mode of teaching, I was like, what's he trying to do? So it took me a moment to relax into it. But nonetheless, super fun way to be together. And we got to be with a lot of Lucidity sisters and brothers out there, as you could see. Very, very beautiful. So that's what inspired, one of the things that inspired us to create our Embody Dance Challenge this week. So come and join our sisterhood. So you'll look up on Facebook. We'll put it in the comments here if you can see it too. Might not be able to do that. So yeah, just Embody Sisterhood with Himalaya. And it's our Facebook group. It's a private group. It's for us women to be in connection together, to be in safety, to be in witnessing of each other, holding each other, and expansion together. So that's really what we're doing there. And so come and join us, especially today. We start our dance challenge, and we've started it already. So we've got like our theme, grab that money, be in pleasure, be in girls just gotta have fun. Yes, be in that energy and watch what happens by the end of this week. Truly get into that energy. Commit to it. Commitment is such a huge piece to you and your expansion. It was a huge piece for me too. I'm telling you. Whoo-wee. The commitment is on high right now. Even this show, this series, Embody Freedom series, is my commitment to keep it moving. Keep us, whoever's playing, in the zone of freedom and play and pleasure and fun and bringing incredible leaders together like who we have today, Shazia Imam. We're so, so grateful. Let's bring her back and let's do our
Yay!
DTO in the house. Wait, DTO, come back here. DTO, get back in there. Show your face, DTO. DTO just does like a little peekaboo. But yeah, shout out to DTO's commitment. Thank you for holding it down. Like, you know, DTO, this was both of our vision here as the coronavirus, you know, the quarantine hit us here in California. The first day we both envisioned, we're like, okay, well, let's start our show then. Let's start our series to support ourselves and each other out there. So DTO's really been doing a lot of work here on the production side of things. He's a genius, those of you who know. And he's been, a lot of people are reaching out to have support by DTO, so get on the waiting list. And seriously, reach out though. He is here to support. He's got a way for you to also build your stuff online. So we've got the Embody Oracle card deck in my hands. I'm gonna knock on them a few times to clear out any energies and bring it into this moment in time. And Shazia, tell me when to stop shuffling.
Stop.
Okay. And then just spray these out here. Tell me when to stop and choose.
Stop.
Humanity, number 35, humanity. Oh, look at this.
Wow, that's beautiful.
I partnered up with an incredible artist and sister, Alexis Cohen, and this is her here, and this is me. I'm the author and visionary of this particular deck. And humanity, the message is, connection and love are your purpose. Sister, it's time to return to your essential truth. You may have become closed and shut down by the toughness of this world or carrying so much responsibility. Life can sometimes be hard, yet you must allow it to disconnect. You must not allow it to disconnect you from your essential nature. You may feel caught in habits and situations that cause you to feel out of touch with what is most meaningful and real. You are here to make a big difference as a leader and help shape a new world. But do not forget that you are human and you need and deserve connection, support, and love. Don't fool yourself into believing that you are so strong you don't need any help. It's time to let your guard down. The weight you carry on your shoulders isn't meant to be carried alone. Your essential mission is to experience life with all of us. Open up to your friends and family. Relax into being supported and knowing we're all in this together. Your mission, vision, and dreams are very important. More importantly, it's all about how you are loving, growing, and connecting with a supportive community. So every message has a embody invitation. This invitation, we're not going to read them just because it would get so long to read, but let's just say this invitation for this particular message that you just received is to hug yourself. If you've got someone there, hug them as well. And really come into that true essential nature of who you are, which is love. And so take a deep breath into that. Exhale. Awesome. Thank you for being here. Thank you, Shazia, for shining your light in the world. Keep on glowing it, girl. The world needs you and your leadership.
Thank you for having me, and thank you for doing what you're doing. And oh, that card just hit home. Thank you for the hugs.
No, oh, good. You can find Shazia Imam at The Life Engineer on, thelifeengineer.com is her website, and then The Life Engineer at for Instagram. So send her a message, reach out. She is here to be of service to you and to us, and we will see you in the Embody Dance Challenge, sisters. Sisters in the house, come on out and play and move and notice. Watch what will happen when you create these dance videos by the end of the week. What will open up for you? That's the invitation. Come on in and join us. We're sending you out with blasts of love. Woo! Thank you for being here with us.